say, love me, leave me, let me be lonely. You won't believe me, but I love you only. I'd rather be lonely than happy with somebody else.
My name is Jan Teeter, and I've worked on and off at Amical for a collective time of about 5 years. Right around the time of, it must have been early 2009, Kyle Mosier was the executive chef at Amical. He just asked me kind of, you know, have you ever thought about going to culinary school? Is this something that you really want to do? And I think he brought the question up because I had shown a lot of interest in the development of specials and things around Amical and, you know, was kind of showing my interest and love for food and things like that. So he approached me about that, and it planted a little seed in my mind. So I waited about a month and decided at that point in time that I wanted to go off to New England Culinary Institute. It so happens that that was the school that Kyle went to, but I chose that school primarily just because the opportunity it gave you to travel around. I knew that I wanted to travel, and I figured that if I could do this along with my schooling as well, that I would kind of kill two birds with one stone. With New England Culinary Institute, you would spend about 6 months on campus in Vermont, where the school is located, and then they would ship you off for 6 months on a self-driven internship. And that would be something that I would set up on my own, and I knew at that point I could just kind of use these internships to kind of travel around the states and see different cuisines and different places all in one shot. So that's what I did. First internship, I chose to go to Portland, Oregon, and I worked at kind of like, it's like an upscale Oaxacan Mexican restaurant called Trebol. It was a smaller format than Amical, probably about half the number of seats. Big bar, 90 tequilas on the wall, and we had a rooftop garden. It was pushing organic food and things like that, so it was a lot of fun. It was a good experience. I had never really worked with dried chilies before much, and now they're kind of like a staple of what I would consider is my own kind of cuisine that I've kind of come up with. And after that, I reported back to Vermont for another 6 months of school and picked a new internship, and this time I chose to go to Chicago. After landing in Chicago, I just did a little research and hit the pavement with staging. It's basically kind of coming in and trying out at different restaurants and stuff. And I actually discovered Girl and the Goat while searching around online. And I took a look at their menu, and their menu was really intriguing. It's a small plate menu is what they call it, so it's similar to, like, I guess tapas would be the best way to put it, but they're not calling it tapas because it's not necessarily small shared plates or whatnot, and tapas is typically, you know, a lot of times it's pushed as Mediterranean cuisine. At Girl on the Goat, Stephanie's style, she likes to call it something fake Chinese. Stephanie likes to call some of her style as fake Chinese. And she uses a lot of Asian ingredients as kind of like a backbone or kind of like a foundation flavor behind many of her sauces. So fish sauce shows up in the menu all over the place, and even in spots where you never thought it would be. So, you know, you taste a sauce from her, whether it be like, you know, a glaze on the pork ribs that she does, or, you know, an aioli that goes on top of the pig face, or, you know, a marinade for, you know, the octopus dish or the sepia dish. And fish sauce just shows up over and over again. And that's kind of like her, her stock, almost. Like, whereas, you know, you go to a French kitchen and the backbone of a lot of their sauces is their veal stock. Well, hers tends to be fish sauce, kind of coupled with a smoked goat stock. Those are the two things that are really showing up in her cuisine a lot. Working at Amical as a line cook during dinner service, kind of filling different roles, whether it be saute or appetizer, or the wheel or whatnot, really worked to build my confidence. The cookbook series in the winter time, month to month, was always a really big highlight for me, just because it really broke you out from what was kind of like, you know, typical Amical fare. And it was interesting because, you know, new ingredients would come in and I wouldn't really know how to use them. I would just turn and look at, you know, John Eakes at the time, and he knew, you know, at the time when I was younger, you know, he knew everything about what was going on with those. And even if it was a new ingredient for him, he seemed to, you know, he knew what to do with it. Having the opportunity to work on these different different people's menus, whether it be Jamie Oliver or an Asian menu or an Indian menu, really helped to develop, you know, my awareness of, you know, other cultures' cuisines, and then also like my interest in them too, where I wanted to learn more about that. Maybe I wanted to take it a little bit further than just the week that we spent, you know, on somebody's cookbook. So I think, you know, having a cookbook series in Travers and Amical's is a really cool way for the public to learn about some different cuisines that they might not have access to being in Travers, and also for everybody that's behind the whole operation to kind of broaden the horizons as well.
I'd rather be lonely than happy with somebody else. You might find the night time the right time for kissing. Nighttime is my time for just reminiscing. Regretting instead of forgetting with somebody else. There'll be no one unless that someone is you. I intend to be independently blue. Hey, I want your love, don't want to borrow. Have it today to give back tomorrow. Your love is my love is your love. There's no love.